He said he did it. He said he did it. So we're going to find out what he said, and then we're going to decide if we believe what he said. 1 Thessalonians chapter 2, verse 13. And I'm using the King James. I want to make sure you know that, because it's the one Jesus used. You know, I love saying that. I particularly love saying that when I'm out on the road somewhere and I'm home here, so people hear me say it all the time. But out on the road, you'd be amazed how people respond to it. Some of them, you can just see their head, yes, yes. That is what he used, hallelujah. Yeah. But anyway, here we go. Verse 13. For this cause, also thank we God without ceasing. Now, let me remind you, this is Paul talking, okay? Paul is writing this to the Thessalonians, and this is what he has to say. For this cause, also thank we God without ceasing, because when you received, pay attention to this one, look, this verse can, everything about you can be, we can get out of here real fast if you pay attention. Amen? I mean, real fast. This one verse can do everything for you, this one verse. For this cause, also thank we God without ceasing, because when you received the word of God, which you heard of us, you received it not as the word of men, but as it is in truth the word of God, which effectually worketh also in you that believe. Now, what he's saying here is that Paul is saying, when I came to teach you and came to explain the things of God to you, you did not act as if it was me, Paul, talking to you. But you received what I had to say as if God himself were talking to you. And, look at the scripture, and because you received it that way, he says, because you did, it then works in you. If you believe that the word that's being preached to you, the word that's being told to you, if you believe it and you receive it, it will produce what it says it will produce, is what that scripture is saying. Notice it's dependent on how you receive it. And Paul is saying, the word is working. This we could almost, like the song we sing, the word is working mightily in me. Paul is saying it's going to work mightily in you because you received the word I gave you, what I told you about Jesus. And what I told you who he was and what he has done, you took it as if God himself were speaking to you. Now, let me say this to you tonight. All of us who are born again, the Holy Spirit of God lives inside of us. When I speak tonight, I pray that you will not hear Sandra Kennedy say one single word. I pray you will hear the voice of God talking to you. Because what I have to say is from this book. And I'm going to quote to you what he said. I'm going to tell you what he said. When I give my opinion, I'll say, this is my opinion. But unless I say that, I'm quoting to you the word of God, what God himself is saying to you tonight. And if you receive it that way, and if you will believe it, God has a word for me tonight. And if you will take it that way, the Bible says it will bring results in your life. It will effectually, it will begin to work in anybody and everyone who would believe what the Word of God says. Now, let's clear up a few little things that mess us up sometimes. We come to a healing meeting or a healing service or a miracle service or whatever. I am not a healer. I cannot heal anyone. I teach the Word of God. Matter of fact, what I do, anybody can do. Anybody can do. Anyone in here can do. Anyone in here can pick up the Word of God and teach the Word of God, and somebody can, and you can get results for yourself or somebody else who's listening. If you're born again, washed in the blood of the Lamb, you can get results from them. You'll see God just do it because God will honor His Word. He will honor and do what He says He will do. Now, the problem with us is that we don't believe that way. And most of us are going to sit here and we're going to have to process every single thing through religion. And religion will kill you. I'm saying religion and tradition will kill you. And so you'll sit there and you will process it. And you'll process, well, I don't know if I believe that, or I haven't experienced that, or they don't teach me that at my church. Da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. And so based on what you think about what you will hear will determine the results that you will get tonight. And then most people think, they get confused with healing and miracles. They get, all healings are miracles. Don't misunderstand me. But there are many things that once you begin to believe, it's like turning on the valve. It begins, the healing power begins to work in your body. You begin to respond. The Word of God begins to work the minute you release and believe. Most people, let's put it this way, if they don't feel something instantly in their body, or if they don't see something happen instantly, they think that they have totally missed everything and that God has skipped over them and that it's not working. In other words, if you do not receive an instantaneous miracle, people will end up saying, well, I guess I didn't get it. I've been doing this for years, so I know what I'm talking about. They will say, I didn't get it. And then they'll begin to feel, and they'll begin to see, well, has the lump gone? Has the bump gone? Has the pain gone? I don't feel any different, so I must not have gotten anything. That is exactly what the devil wants you to think. He wants you to think that the Word of God is not working in you, and if you don't see an instant result, he wants you to think that nothing's happening. That's not what the Bible teaches. Glory to God. So let's get it straight. Now, let's go back over. Let's go to Proverbs chapter 4. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Proverbs chapter 4. And let's read beginning there in verse 22. You already know all this. Here we go. Do you know you can know it and not know it? So we're trying to know it. I want you to know that you know it. The problem is you think you know it and you don't know it. But I want you to know that you know it. Amen. If you know that you know it, you'll get it. Amen. And you won't get it until you know it. Yes. You just won't get it until you know it. And you already think you know it. Well, why hadn't you gotten it? Because you don't know it. All right, so here we go. All right, Proverbs chapter 4. Let's pick up in verse 20, actually, 4:20. My son, my daughter, attend to my words, incline thine ear unto my saying. Now, notice what he's saying. He's saying, pay attention. So let's get this straight. You can be here and not be here. In other words, you can be sitting here in the meeting and be somewhere else. Your brain be just somewhere. You can be here and you can be sitting here and you can be at some ball game or you can be down the street or you can be somewhere and not even be here. He's saying to you, pay attention to my word. Amen. Are you listening? All right, this is the Word of God. This is what he says to it. My son, pay attention to my words. Incline your ear unto my sayings. Let them not depart from thine eyes. Keep them in the midst of thine heart. Now, right there, I've already answered for a pile of folks why you're not seeing anything happen in your life. And I hadn't even finished the verse. But I've already answered for you part of the problem. Why isn't this working? Because you're not working. Because you're not doing these things. Yeah. Preach, Pastor. Let me get this back up. Well, two things already been said. It says, pay attention to his words. Hear what he's saying. Keep them in front of you. Now, let me say this. If I need healing, I do not need to read about Armageddon. Right. Okay? I don't need to be memorizing Revelation. Right. If I need healing, I need to know what the Bible has to say about healing. And I need to keep those scriptures in front of my eyes. I need to incline mine ear. I need to hear on the inside. You got two sets of ears. You got these on your body. Then you got the ears of the spirit man. And it's your spirit man. Healing starts on the inside. So it's the inside that I'm trying to get to tonight. I'm trying to get past what I'm looking at. Because I'm just looking at bodies looking back at me. I'm looking at bodies with problems. The body has problems. Yes. I'm trying to get past the problem to the part of you that has no problem. All right. All right. You are a spirit created in the image of God. Your spirit man is, if you're born again, made in the image of God. The Holy Spirit lives inside of you. And your spirit man is not sick. Your spirit man has ears. So I'm trying to get you. Remember, you are a spirit. The Holy Spirit moved inside of your spirit man. So you are a spirit. And the Holy Spirit moved inside of you. I'm trying to get you to hear God's word. The real you. The real you that's not sick. The real you that's well. The real you that the Bible said is getting better every single day. Now that ought to put a smile on everybody's face. I mean, thank God you're getting better. Now the problem is, again, we don't even think we're getting better. When you look in the mirror, you say, dear God, don't nothing look better. I mean, you know, so you can't go by what you see in the mirror. Well, as I look around, you should be shouting over that one, too. You remember, just as much as you looking at me, I'm a looking at you. Hallelujah. Amen. All right. Now, let's finish the scripture. Then it says, keep them in the midst of thine heart. Keep God's word in your heart. And that means this is what God said. So I need to keep what God said in my heart. And then it says, for they are life unto those that find them. What is life? The word of God is life to those that find them. That means that you may not find them. That means that you could be reading the word and not find out what the word means. That means you could sit in church every single day of your life and still not know one single thing about what God is saying. That means you could read your Bible and not really understand one single thing you're reading because you're just kind of reading through it. But if you meditate on it, if you think about it, then God says you will find it. And if you find what the Word is really saying, look at your neighbor and say, I'm going to get it. The Bible is saying, it says that it is life to those that find them. Those who find the Word of God, those who do what I've been talking about, those who take that Word and say, this is a Word for me. Point to yourself tonight and say, I'm getting a Word from God tonight. Tell somebody else, say, I'm getting a Word from God tonight. Now, for everybody who will say, does she think she's God? I know I'm not God, and let's get that straight. But I do know this. I know this Bible is God talking to you. Amen. And I do know when I read this Bible, I'm giving you a word from God. Amen. I do know that. Hallelujah. So you're getting a direct word from God tonight when I read His word to you and I deliver it to you. That's God talking to you. Hallelujah. I'm the delivery boy. Glory to God. All right. Now, here we go. And He says, it's life to those that find them and health or medicine to all of your flesh. Now, let's get it straight. It's the flesh. It's the body that has the problem. So there is, and this what I just read to you says, if you grab hold of, if you listen, if you pay attention, if you pull it to your heart, if you keep it in front of your eyes, the Word of God, you meditate on it, you think on it, it becomes more powerful to you than anything else. You grab hold of it, hallelujah. This Bible says, God says that Word that you find and you make it yours and you pull it to your bosom, the Bible says it will bring health and healing and be medicine to your body. Glory to God. Well, hallelujah. I'm having a good time. Thank you, Jesus. Now, everything that God does for us, He does through His Word. That's why this book is so very important. You have to hear. You say, well, I've heard this before. Most of you can quote every scripture I quote. Quoting scriptures, that's not what gets it. I mean, you can quote scriptures all day long. It's not quoting scriptures. It's knowing. It's knowing in your knower. I did a teaching 100 years ago. Knowing in your knower. It's down inside. See what the word, I taught it 100 years ago. Look how good I still look. Hallelujah. See, I'm telling you, the word, once you get it, the Bible says it's health, medicine, healing to your flesh. Yeah. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Now, everything that God does, everything, He does it through the word. I sent my word and healed you. I sent, Jesus is the word. I sent my word. I sent my word. I sent my word. I gave you my word. I give you my word. And in this word, there is healing.
Yes.
Now, that should say up front to anybody and everybody, right off the bat, it should say, the one thing I need is the word of God.
Amen.
I need to get the word of God in me. I need to understand the word of God. It doesn't mean that you have to memorize the whole Bible. It has nothing to do with how many Sunday school pens you have. It has nothing to do with how many years you've gone to church. It has nothing to do with how many times you've read the Bible. It has to do with what you know about what the Bible says and if you have made it yours. I'm just repeating myself because I want us to get it. That you have taken that one, he sent his word and healed me. I could take that one scripture, meditate on it. Okay, he sent his word and healed me. He sent it. He's already done it. I'm not waiting on him to send it. He's already done it. He sent his word and healed me. All right, it's already happened. Praise God. Well, dear God, what am I waiting on? It's here. You see, this process you have to go through. Well, I'm not trying to get him to do something. He's already done something. I'm not trying to get him to send something. He's already sent something. He sent his word. He thinks he's healed me. Did you? God thinks he has already healed us.
Yes.
Amazing. It's amazing that God thinks such a thing. Guess what the Bible says? By the stripes of Jesus. Some of you kind of, what does it say there? Maybe we better go over to 2 Peter. Let's go. Let's go to Peter. Let's go to Peter. Thessalonians and go to the left. Hallelujah. 1 Peter 2:24. 1 Peter 2:24. The Bible says anybody who comes to him, he will in no wise cast out. So tonight, what we're saying is, I'm coming to you. Now, we're doing the reverse now. We're not asking God to come to us. Let me get it straight. We're not saying, God, come to me. Now, some of you came in here and said, oh, God, come to me. Oh, God, heal me. He said, anybody who comes to him, he will not cast out.
Right.
Now, I made a statement. God, from God's point of view, if you were to go to the Lord God Almighty and you were to say, Lord, what do you think about the doctor's report? What do you think? This is what they're saying. This is what's happening. Lord, what do you think about it? You know what he would say? I think you're healed. I'm just talking about God now. What he would think. You say, well, how can you say that? Well, it's just because that's what he says. Okay, 1 Peter 2:24. Look at it. Who his own self bare our sins in his own body on the tree. Now, let's stop right there for just a second. That's pretty amazing. Everybody in here who says you are born again, washed in the blood of the Lamb, and you say that you're on your way to heaven and you are born again. How many of y'all believe that?
Amen.
Yes. What's the matter with the rest of you? How many we believe that? Born again. You've asked Jesus into your life. You're born again. Then you have to believe the first part of this scripture. Look at it. Who his own self bare our sins in his own body on the tree, that we being dead to sin should live unto righteousness. Now that is an amazing scripture. And all of we just pass over it like it's nothing. We sit in here and we say, well, praise God, I'm born again. I'm on my way to heaven. Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God. That is a much bigger statement than talking about healing. Healing is a patch-up job. Hello? Healing is a patch-up job for earth. Because one day, if the Lord should tarry, we all are going to leave this body and step out of it and go on to heaven if we believe the first part of that verse. So don't tell me you can't believe, because you believe something. You either believe this is true or you don't believe this is true. And everybody sitting in here is telling me that he took your sins in his body and that we, being dead to sin. He says we're dead to sins.
Yes.
Did you notice that?
Yes.
We being dead, you said you believe this now. We being dead to sins should live unto righteousness. He's saying that you, well, we're all sitting, you and I are sitting here saying, I believe that. And then we have a hard time believing that God can heal us. We're sitting here saying, we believe he took our sins. We believe we don't even have to walk in sins anymore. We believe we don't have to sin and that we can walk uprightly and righteous every single day.
Amen.
That's what that scripture says.
Yes.
I can see it in your faces. Well, I don't know that I believe all that. I see it all over you. Well, I didn't say I believe that. Hallelujah. I just believe I'm going to heaven. Well, that's what he means. That's what he wants you to believe.
Yes.
He wants you to believe that you've been set free.
Yes.
That you've been free from sins.
Yes.
That your sins have been wiped out.
Yes.
That there is no record of them. That you'll never see them again.
Hallelujah.
That Jesus took them and bore them for you. And that you don't have them anymore.
Right.
Whoa! How amazing.
Hallelujah.
And that I can live in righteousness. Huh. Glory to God. Some of you have never in your life said, I am righteous. Let's try it tonight and see if you faint. Here we go. All right. Here we go.
I am righteous.
Now turn to that person that you've acted like an idiot to and still say it. I'm still righteous. Now look, you ought to be getting happy about who you are. You see, if you get happy about who you really are, man, this next part's easy.
Yeah.
Are you listening? This next part's easy. Because look what the next part says. It's a little bit part down here. It says, by whose stripes you were healed. It's like he just tacked it on. You're righteous. Your sins have been forgiven. You've been born from above. God himself moved inside of you. Has nothing to do with feeling. It has to do with believing.
Yes.
If you can believe you're righteous, you certainly can start saying, I'm healed.
Yes.
Look at somebody who knows you, or at least they think you're not healed. Look at somebody who thinks you're not healed and say, I want you to know I'm healed. Oh, man, everything got a little quieter that time. Oh, I could hardly hear anybody. I've got a whole room that everybody needs healing, and I could hardly hear anybody say, I am healed. And all I'm trying to get you to do is say what he said. I'm trying to get you to confess over you what he thinks about you. If you will agree with him, you'll see the manifestation of it begin to happen in your life.
Yeah.
You remember, how many of you remember when you got born again?
Yeah.
Were you a mess? You were a mess, weren't you? Let me tell you what a mess you were. You're on your way to hell. That's how messed up you were. We all were on our way to hell. We were on our way to hell outside of Jesus. Glory to God. And then Jesus, praise his holy name. Somebody told us about him. We fell in love with him.
Yes.
We believed him.
Yes. Woo.
And then we were saved. Hallelujah. Forgiven. On our way to heaven. Born again. Washed in the blood of the Lamb. Hallelujah. And all I have. Do you remember when you first got born again that you didn't look too born again? Do you remember that you didn't act too born again? Some of you may still not act too born again, but the more you believe you are righteous, the more you believe you are righteous, the more you will act righteous. And you release faith in righteousness by saying it. Thank you, Lord, for forgiving me. Thank you for cleansing me. I was a mess, Lord. It's amazing what you've done for me. I praise you for it. I thank you I'm on my way to heaven. I thank you that you're not mad with me. I thank you you've forgiven me. Lord Jesus, I praise you. Now, the more grateful you are about it, and the more you say it, then your life will reflect it. And when I say that, I'm repeating myself because I want you to get it. And the more you say it, then the more victory you will walk in. Some people don't walk in victory because they don't believe that they are victorious. You have to believe you are victorious in order to walk in victory. Now, in order to walk in victory, that means there's a battle, something you overcame. I'm an overcomer, is what the Bible says. In this life. So I'm conquering and I'm going. But it didn't happen instantaneously. We were born again instantaneous. But most of us did not get our act cleaned up instantaneous. But yet, we believe that the moment we asked Jesus into our life, that moment we were born again. How many of you really believe that? Now, I have to admit, it took me a little while And I could not believe that he could forgive me. It took me a long time I just didn't instantaneously. I mean, I saw it, and I was happy for it, but I kept messing up. Oh, y'all look so holy. And it took me a while as I began to see his goodness and his grace and believe his word and take his word and put it in my heart and confess it. Reality of the word began to happen. That's what Paul said. I began to believe it, and then it began to work in me. Now, healing. By his stripes, you were healed. Then he says in Isaiah 53, by the stripes of Jesus, you are healed. In Matthew 8:17, he says that himself took our infirmities and bare our sicknesses. And then here in 1 Peter 2:24, by whose stripes you were healed. You were healed. Were healed. So what does God think about you? He thinks you're healed. So we're asking him the wrong question. We need to get in agreement with him. And we're asking God to do something for us that he says he's already done. You know, are y'all really listening? We need to start saying thank you that you did what you said you'd do. But the problem is, you said, but I don't feel it. I don't feel healed. I don't feel healed. And they say I'm going to die. They say. They say I'm going to die. Da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. One day we all will die. The body. But we don't have to die sick. Of course, I personally believe we could be in the end days. We could be in the crowd that's going to be raptured up. Hallelujah. Now, if you don't want to believe that, fine. Stay here. I'm counting on going with him. Hallelujah.
Please follow us. Keep up with what's happening around us and watch our podcasts. Watch our YouTube channels. We tell you so many things that can change your life forever. I'm thankful that you're following us. God bless.